In chapter 2 now, we start on Fourier series. These are expressions where you write a function as a sum of sine or cosine functions. But can you do this with any function you want, or do you need some special considerations here? We would like to do this for like simple functions, like if you have a continuous function, maybe something like this or so. This would be something we are happy with. But as it turns out, in the study of PDEs, we also need to allow jumps. So we need to allow functions which maybe have a little jump from here to there, and from here to there, and from here to there. Okay? And these functions we call piecewise continuous. Okay, so here in this bit, this function would be continuous. Here's a jump. Here's continuous. Here's a jump. And here's continuous. That's what I basically do in the next 2 or 3 minutes. You might remember on jumps, we can talk about left-sided and right-sided limits, going back to calculus. So that's what I do here. I denote f of x0 plus to be the right-sided limit, and f of x0 minus to be the left-sided limit. And then we have learned already that if the left-sided limit and the right-sided limit coincide, then we have a continuous function. This is what I do right here in number one. If the left and right-sided limits exist, but they are not the same, then we do have a jump. And we call this a discontinuity of the first kind. And there can be two things. It can be that actually just by chance the left and right-sided limits are the same. Let me plot a function of that sort. So maybe here is a function not defined at this point, continuing there. But here, left and right sided limits are the same. So then there would be a removable discontinuity because we just can fill in this point here. A jump discontinuity I plotted already, so it could also look like this, where you jump from one value to the next. Left and right sided limits do exist, but of course they're different. And then discontinuity of the second kind are those which you cannot remove and which is not a jump. So this would typically be something with infinity, okay, from here and here. And here you have a vertical asymptote, which of course you cannot simply remove by putting a point between them. So then here we define piecewise continuous functions. These are functions which are mostly continuous and they might have a few jumps. So important here is we have a finite number of points, where at those points the left and right sided limits exist, but they can have jumps or they can have removable discontinuities. We call the space of all these functions PWC. Okay, so this is now the set of all those functions which have all those properties. And then with these functions we can actually do some mathematics. Okay, so if you have two functions right here, which are piecewise continuous, and the sum is also piecewise continuous, and if we put in alphas and betas in front of f and g, so alpha f plus beta g, it's also piecewise continuous for all alpha, beta. In this means we can do linear combinations, so we're getting a linear space. Then here we say the product is also piecewise continuous. And furthermore, if f is piecewise continuous, we can integrate it, so the integral does exist. Okay, these are wonderful properties. Wonderful properties, and so mathematically we then would say that this is a vector space. We can carry this a little bit further by introducing piecewise smooth. Piecewise smooth means that also the derivative is piecewise continuous. Okay, so not only the function like in item one, but also its derivative is piecewise continuous. So that's a little bit stronger than piecewise continuous. For now though, we should just focus on PWC, piecewise continuous functions. Now, functions can have wonderful properties, so let me talk about them as well, just a little bit. You have seen this before. Right, a function is even if f of minus x equals f of x. So let's plot an even function. So for example, this here would be even. It is odd if f of minus x equals minus f of x, so the minus sign carries through. Okay, so an odd function would be something like this. So it is reflection symmetric at the origin. A function is periodic, periodic with period p, if f of x plus p is f of x. So then, right, so let's draw a sawtooth, which will come up later. We just repeat it periodically, so that would be a periodic function. And then in the context of periodic function, it is important to look at the periodic extension. This is here. So if we have a function f given only on a little bit of an interval, we can always periodically extend it. F bar is f of x plus np, where np then is a period. Okay, so let's do any whatever function. So maybe I do this function here. I define on an interval from 0 to 1. So what is the periodic extension? Well, we extend it periodically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. So the length of the interval. And then we use the same function of on each subinterval. Ah, you know, and there you see already how the jumps arise. Because from one period to the next, you jump from low to up, from down to up, from down to up. So this will be a typical piecewise continuous function, which has been periodically extended. There are other extensions where we can extend a function from positive to negative, and these are the even and the odd extensions. So what happens here is I have a function which is only defined on the positive bit. So maybe I do like part of an exponential function. But now I can extend it in an odd way or in an even way. Okay, that sounds kind of strange, but anyways. So the odd extension, I have the original function first, but now I extend it in the negative with a minus sign. So I take the whole function, I mirror image it to the negative, and so this would be the odd extension. And here, for the even extension, taking the same function, I mirror image it over with a plus sign, so keeping the same function, mirror image, so this would be here, the even extension.